You know, one of the most abusive things I see that happened with the resolution today was the section that says that amendments can be laid on the table, because that does not just affect the minority. It also affects members in the majority party that may have a disagreement with one of their leaders. Well, all one of their leaders needs to do is say, we're going to lay that your amendment on the table today. It allows them the power, a few people, to have the concentrated power to say they can stifle any member on the floor of the House of Representatives, whether they are Republican or Democrat. One of the shining beacons that we've had in our democracy here in Pennsylvania is that we get to go up and say, here's what I think. And you may not agree with me, you may not like it, you can vote me down at the end of the day, but I get a chance to offer that idea on the floor of the House. Under Rule 6, they would have the power to eliminate and stifle anyone's idea on any given day, Republican, Democrat, Independent, whoever they are, and just say, I'm sorry, you're not allowed to bring that idea to the floor today. That is an affront to democracy. That's not just an affront to the minority or the Democrats, or it is an affront to democracy. And on a day when they said we were going to try and do reform, I want to know where their governor is on this. His top issue was supposedly that he was going to reform the legislature, and their first move is an affront to democracy. It's just unconscionable that they would try and pull a procedure like this, stifling members. They also said that, well, we could probably come to some agreement where, at least on really important bills, they'd allow us to offer amendments and have some ideas, but not on a lot of other bills. And yet, the reason they're doing this is because they didn't want to have to run any amendments that were offered to the reform bill. Now, what they're saying apparently is that reform really isn't an important issue. It's just one of those secondary issues that you're not allowed to talk about. Well, their own governor said it was his top issue. And if they're going to allow amendments on top issues, then this is certainly one that they should allow amendments on. I defy anyone to look at the list of amendments that were there, as Representative Frankel pointed out, and categorize any of them as attempts to stifle reform in the state of Pennsylvania. They are good, solid policy amendments that improve the way we do business in Pennsylvania, the transparency that there is for the public, and they have attempted to try and shut that down on day one.